Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue to trigger the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yesterday's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, but it is almost there. Currently sitting at 4.1K on the counter at the time of this recording. Thank you all very much. I'm looking forward to getting that tally as we head on into the brand new weekend here. Happy Friday to you all. Let's make it happen so we can get ever closer to the live Q&A session along with the Repentance tier list recording session. I'm looking forward to that. I know a lot of people are as well. Here's your meme of the day. This was more of a screenshot of the day brought to you by Mr. Moffert. Title of the thread was 200 new room layouts. Thanks, Edmund. Yeah, I was doing the T at the same time of trying to say thanks. So thank you very much to Mr. Moffert and all 197 y'all. Yeah, I'm not sure how you got stuck there or even got in that room, but I love that. Today is going to be 07 Zulu Golf Kilo Quebec 6 Deuce. We've got great tears rate, good damage to start with, good movement speed, along with Guppy's Paw and the Blood Clot as well, which is an item that is going to give us a shot that gives us a little bit of extra damage every now and then out of our, it's every other shot essentially, along with a little bit of extra range out of there as well. Blood Clot's not necessarily, I would say, one of the sexier tiers upgrades or the tier effects, I should say. But, you know, it does its job. Get a random free soul heart. We'll take that. We'll also take Fat on Mushroom. It's going to give us a red heart. A little bit of a speed down as well, but we have, well, we didn't really have a lot of speed to give, but I think in this case, it's not that horrible. Fat on Mushroom is going to give us the speed down and a damage up, which is very good. Also, of course, contributes to the 1 out of 3 for the Fungi transformation. And it's a generally, you know, it's a pretty good upgrade. There's nothing real special about it, I would say, other than the fact that, like, you know, it shows up quite often and it is just a nice HP damage combo up. So, you know, that's better than what you can say about a lot of the items in Isaac. And we'll definitely take it. So looking to get some movement speed back here, along with the getting a nice little damage up, some tears up maybe. Maybe we'll run into a new item or two. I should say that I have updated the external information mod, so it is current with all of the latest items. Now, I have not seen all the extra items that we currently have in the game as of version 1.7.5. The only one that I've seen so far has been Sty. We briefly checked out C-section, but it is, we didn't test a whole lot about it, but that item is an absolute trip. Mom's underwear here, and might as well open up the other one, and we get Glass Eye, 0.75 damage up and a luck upgrade. So we actually did get this item, spoiler alert, on Thusmas. Don't miss today's Thusmas, by the way. It is a it's a humdinger, let me tell you that. Hutz and I did talk, about at length a lot of the changes for the patch notes. I didn't record the discussion part because it literally was just an hour and a half of me and Hutz just like talking, which I know that some people would like to hear, but you know, I did put it on the, it is on my Twitch channel. We'll take Dreamcatcher. It's not a bad first floor buy because it's obviously going to give us a half soul heart every time we go to a new room or new floor, I should say. It also allows us to see what items are coming up, so it's, you know, it's fairly useful. I'm loving our damage right now. 6.10 damage thanks to Glass Eye. And, you know, I'm super happy that we're getting some items that are just straight up just good stat ups. You know, Sty is very good. Glass Eye is very good. I don't know what Mom's Ring does. But apparently, according to Hutz, that's also very good. So, you know, we got 3 new items and they're all just bangers. And I'm all for that. Anything that helps us out a little bit and damage wise, I'm going to be happy about. So with 6.10 damage here, Limehorn is not going to be a happy horn at all. And I don't think I want to know what a happy horn looks like. We'll leave that to the imagination of the internet. Yeah, I mean, we're basically two-shotting all of the Dark Matter balls, and it's not looking good for old Limehorn here. So what are your thoughts on all the changes, the patch and everything, now that we are 24 hours out of having it? Those of you on console, have you updated yet? Are you going to update? I'd love to hear your thoughts down below. I think that was chocolate milk, and if it was, I definitely don't want it. Our tears rate is good enough right now without me having to manually fire for an entire run. Also get a nickel as well. We're getting lots of help here on these random drops. We'll definitely take it. Give me sloth here. And, you know, Guppy's paw is okay to have. If I really, really wanted to, I could get rid of one of our HP upgrades here, but I would take Bob's Rotten Head over Guppy's Paw. Turns out I'm not going to have to worry about that because we didn't get it anyway. Star's card is going to take us to our item room here, save us the key, which we don't have. Yeah, the fact that we can almost mow these things down without them getting to us just is a testament of how good our early game damage is here. Secret room should be there. I'm not going to use our only bomb just in case. We can bomb into the store, however, if we do get another one. And with 16 cents, that's definitely enough for me to warrant to getting into the store. Unless, of course, the secret room's not there. I guess I never considered that being a possibility. Okay. Yep, and that was chocolate milk. So there, I think there's a time and a place for chocolate milk. I don't think it's here. If our tears rate was horrible and our damage was really, really bad, I would definitely consider it. But given the fact that that's not the case, then I'm not overly concerned about it. So there's our super secret room in a very sort of weird spot for it to be. And we're going to save ourselves a bomb here by not having to use one on these stone chests. We can just push them in range of the barrels here. We can just push this into range of the barrels here and get an item. A nice tears up. The screw. Shot speed as well. I'm not going to take old capacitor. Even though we have no use for it right now, it still doesn't really... It's not that useful to us. Even if we had a good space for item. Now, we had something like the D1 or, like, you know, Battery Baby or something like that where we could profit from those full charges from old capacitor, then I would consider it. Go back into the store here. Membership card, I mean... Do we think that we're going to get enough money to have it matter or not? I guess we'll find out. And a 42-cent revelation, and we don't know what this is. A pay-to-win trinket is also nice, but 42 cents, and obviously, again, without us being able to bomb the donation machine means that we're just not going to get anything out of there. It's odd that this room is considered to be in combat, even though we were the ones who spawned the enemies that were, quote, in combat there. So we cleared the room, and then we made it unclear because we teleported out with the stars card. Now, the sacrifice room is also interesting, but I think it would be foolish. I think it would be foolish to take the sacrifice room. Do we think that we would be able to get 37 cents out of... a sack room? I don't think so. And even then, as much as I like Revelation, it's not worth 42 cents. We can get so much more than Revelation for 42 cents. You know, especially with member card, we can get some, you know, something even better. So I honestly think the play here is to try, if we are going to play the sacrifice room, I think it's to go for pay to win. And that allows us to reroll the item pedestals inside of the item room, which is very, very powerful. Again, with the assumption that we do have enough money to actually make it happen, or at least worthwhile anyway. The latch key, which gives us a charge key. I'm going to leave that behind right now. And this devil deal is quite terrible. I think this HP, I mean, we can... No. We could have played the charge beggar or the demon beggar there, but honestly, I think the HP is better off either staying with us or with us trying to make at least 15 cents to get the pay to win. Now, we still have not found where our secret room is, and I'm more inclined to believe it's here at this point. It can still be here. Maybe it can't be there because that poop pile. That's a hard call. It's easier to test from this side here. Yeah, I didn't think it was there. I don't know. The secret room might be in a weird place. So we are going to be a little bit greedy here and also a little bit dangerous by going and playing the sack room. We get 3 cents. Okay. We get Immaculate Heart. Oh, and we also get a heart container as well, which is just super awesome. Okay, so the next one is Uriel, which we're just going to swoop and dupe out of here. And then the next one should be the Soul Heart. So we got a pretty massive upgrade there in Immaculate Heart. And hopefully we can get... We're not going to make the money to get pay to win, unfortunately. Unless if we use a bomb, which we don't have, on the donation machine. So the next one, 7 Soul Hearts or 30 coins. Well, I guess that is another way that we could get it. Is if we don't get our 7 Soul Hearts, we'll get the 30 coins. So it's actually, this is actually, I guess, fine with me. There's still enough HP for us not to feel threatened. And if we do feel threatened, we can use Guppy's Paw, convert one of our Red Heart containers to Soul Hearts, and still have a chance of getting an Angel Deal on the next floor. So it's that's honestly fine with me. So I say that we go. Oh, and we can buy that Soul Heart in there too. So we're going to say no to, oh man, I should have looked at this. This could have been a Yara rune right here. Not say it was, yeah, we take pay to win. We're not going to buy anything else except the Soul Heart. And what are we leaving here? It was, oh yeah, chocolate milk. Yeah. So that's a pretty big time play. Sacrifice rooms again, they're going up in my flow chart of good items, or good strategies, I should say. Especially with it being able to reliably get you, or at least have a 33% chance to reliably get you an Angel Deal item, that is pretty pogged. That a Daddy Long Legs? I saw. I think it was. We're gonna try to get Daddy Long Legs here, and that is a welcome addition to the team. Immaculate Heart doing gangbusters for us. We got the Moon Card, Hero Font Card, which I will take. Obviously, and a Moon Card as well, which will take us to the Secret Room. Magician Card. I didn't want you here, but I guess sure. Come on, why not? There we go. So Immaculate Heart is causing those tears that you see to randomly rotate around us every now and then. And it is a fantastic... I used to not like it just because it was... It's a little unnerving to have your tears just fly around everywhere. But now that, you know, you see the potential, the huge amount of damage, and plus the HP up that you get from it, it is absolutely worth it. Nunce Habits there. We don't really have a space problem that we can benefit from that of. I do want to take... I want to find our item room so we can use our reroll pedestal in there, thanks to pay to win. Get a key for a penny, not exactly a great trade there. In fact, it's one of the worst trades that we could have had, besides nothing. Monetary-wise, it's definitely the worst trade that could have happened. There was an invisible NASA worm there, I think, or something? In a weird way, Immaculate Heart's almost like a better Tiny Planet because you don't have to worry about the tears always going around Isaac, but it can still give you that Tiny Planet-esque type effect while having a massive damage bonus included in its package. So whereas Tiny Planet doesn't give you a damage bonus at all. We shouldn't... Let's use our Moon Card just to save us time to go across the map. Get a Strength Card, which... we can use it on... If we really wanted to, we could use this on the Strength Card. We can combine it with Guppy's Paw to get ourselves a little bit of extra synergy there. Normally, I would say the Secret Room's to the right of here. It's Gigante Bean. I enjoyed that build yesterday. A lot of people did too, actually. You know, the like counter definitely showed it. You know, Daddy Long Legs, we don't need Daddy Long Legs necessarily. Definitely don't need that. It hurts. It does give us a tears up. Our tears are already quite good. Shot speed and HP. It's better now. All right, we'll stick with Maggie's bow and just convert it to soul hearts. I'm fine with that. We honestly, like, the play there would, in hindsight, would have been just to stick with Daddy Long Legs. But I appreciate us having the ability to reroll stuff just to see if we can get better. That's the thing about Isaac, is that you always want to, you know, you don't want to get too greedy, obviously, but if you have a chance to possibly vastly increase the quality of life in your runs for only the cost of like one reroll, then I say definitely try it out. Not always, you know, every situation in Isaac is different, obviously, but, you know, use your best judgment to decide whether or not rerolling an item, you know, other than, you know, is this item too good to reroll? Should you take it? Should you not take it? That sort of thing. We get booster pack. We get a Joker card, an Ace of Clubs, and a Reverse Hermit card. Definitely want to take the Joker card, and it's going to take us to Breath of Life and Halo. I think it's not going to be any surprise on which one we take here. And then I say that let's use the Lover's card and then use the Ace of Clubs. Before we do that, let's take the Reverse Hermit card and drop it out here so we can actually gain some more money for it. Then we can use this for bombs. Perfection. I'm sorry, but I mean, we paid a lot of money to get pay to win, so we're going to get some use out of it, dang it. I don't know if that was that Lacrophagy or was that something different? That couldn't have been Blood Puppy. Maybe Berserk? I'm not sure. That looked weird. I think it might have been Lacrophagy. Dreamcatcher shows you the item that you get, by the way, in your item room upon the stage transition. But I guess was it showing us the boss and I wasn't paying attention, or was that removed in 1.7.5? Secret room is going to be below here. Very obvious secret room. You can see the arrow pointing down here. If you look at this as the left side of an arrow, and this is the right side of an arrow, and like this sort of like pizza crust shape, like you see how it kind of comes down to a point here. Basically, it points its way to the secret room pretty much almost every time. And that holds true for a lot of things in Isaac. And people, you know, a lot of people said, I don't know what Simic is talking about. He's crazy. We can actually take that. I wonder if we should have actually used our Hermit card. Does the Hermit card take... No, Hermit card only takes pickups off the ground. It doesn't take item pedestals, I don't think, anyway. It was Lacrophagy, so I'm gonna wait for Immaculate Heart to dissipate before I decide to bomb. Bro. Since one of these bombs have this like pixel perfect placing all of a sudden. The new IBS. I'm going to take it only because Hudson and I talk about this item extensively on Thusmas, and I want to see how it works. The old IBS was absolute trash because of the way that Explosive Diarrhea came out. Context. With the new IBS, supposedly it works like Kidney Stone. Okay, so it's about to... So it has not interrupted the flow of our attacks yet. And it only threw out one poop. So that's promising. Ooh, man. Do we take the Soul of Eden for 3 cents? I say we do. Consolation prize would give us movement speed, I believe, which honestly I'm kind of down for. Yeah, I'm actually 100% fine with that. So the Soul of Eden is going to give us a reroll with basically chaos. Oh man, look at our shot speed. All of a sudden the tears have started going insane. So yeah, so Isaac does indeed flash red, much like Kidney Stone whenever IBS is about to proc. And then you let go of it, and then that's when it happens. So you have to let go of the fire button in order for you to fire off the IBS attack. Now, does it persist through rooms? That's what I want to know. I'm going to use the Temperance Machine in here. Get back some of this money. Okay, so I got hit there and I did not let go of the fire button. So IBS will still fire if anything interrupts the flow of you attacking, including getting hit. Okay, so I'm not going to launch IBS here. I'm just going to hold it out. Okay, and we got hit, of course, at the last second, and that caused us to drop Hologram. We did not get an Angel Deal or Devil Deal, so 73%. Still in good fashion here. I will use a bomb to get this key. Now I'm going to go back in and use the reverse hermit card. I'm going to drop these two out here so it doesn't get rerolled or doesn't get turned into consumables. And I'm just testing this to see if it actually works on non-pedestal items. No, it just gives you a penny. Okay. Fair enough. And I don't know if IBS works in whenever you're not in like a combat situation room. But I want to see if it persists through rooms or if it dissipates like after you're done. Super Secret Room's probably here, I would say. Oh man, that would have been the room to use the reverse hermit card in for sure. So holding on fire. By the way, we healed double from Maggie's bow. That's the reason why that heart healed us for so much. So holding fire just to see if IBS will proc. So far, it doesn't look like it procs unless you're inside of an active room. Didn't actually mean to do that, but here we are. Got our bomb back anyway, so. We'll head on to Zaun. We're going to be fighting Stitches and Fallen. And it did show us the boss that we're fighting, so I just missed it on the other floors. I wasn't really paying attention. Stitches obviously is going to be one of our reroll targets. Not really an item that I'm going to... I mean, we could, like, I guess there's no reason for us not to reroll Guppy's Paw if we're not going to use it. Okay, so I'm still holding IBS here, and IBS does indeed persist through rooms. So that's good to know. Oh, that was a butt bomb. And our damage is still kicking. Another butt bomb. I need to stop shooting my butt bombs away. We can actually, we might get some use out of IBS. I don't know if there's, I'm not sure if luck plays any part in how often it procs. We get a global D6 here, which we will use. Pick this soul heart as well. Not going to use the global D6 yet because I think I want to try to reroll first and then we'll use the global D6. Also known as the four room. 31 cents down. Got a poison cloud that didn't poison anyone. So I'm not sure if... Just missed it. I mean, it looked like we dropped it right on top of that Gish, but apparently not. Well, we're already here, so we might as well fight Fallen. And yes, indeed, that right there confirms it. If you take damage while you're holding on to the IBS charge, it will go off. So just be aware of that. Taking way too much damage right now. Spectral Tears doesn't really do anything for us. Get the body, which... yeah. Don't really want the body. We already have enough HP as it is. Actually did get a little bit of benefit there from IBS. And we don't really want to use the... we don't really want these golden... These Eternal Chests either because we don't have enough keys for them. So I think what we do... is we just re-roll the key piece. Oh, accidentally ran into that, and then we got shot by Gabriel anyway, of course. So we want that. We want the bomb as well. Soul of Eden. It's Scorpio, and we get another HP upgrade anyway. Scorpio I'm okay with. There's nothing wrong with the body, it's just that this is not a red heart HP build that we really want. But again, you could make the argument that, well, you've got Guppy's Paw, just simply use Guppy's Paw to get the shed the unwanted excess red heart HP, and then then you don't have anything to worry about. Need some good extra money here. Some more IBS, and we just get the poison cloud. Lots of poison on this build here, thanks to Scorpio and Immaculate Heart spreading it around. I love it. Taking all this damage. There's the hallowed ground or holy poop. Ooh, man, that's spicy right there. Okay, so I think that we're going. I guess I'll just stick with Guppy's Paw, just in case if we need that emergency HP. Sorry, Stitches. It gives us more tier height for some reason. I don't want more tier height. Our tiers rate is already pretty good enough. I'm looking for damage here or movement speed. We got almost 3 luck. I'll take Tough Love. So we have not found the store yet. Very slow moving run here. We get Black Candida, which I am going to take immediately because we don't want any more curses and we don't have to worry about them now. Damage upgrade here from meat. Also, I believe it heals us for a little bit. And yeah, we have enough money to make the next reroll pedestal worthwhile. I guess we can go use that D6. We didn't look in the membership, or did we? Losing my mind. Oh, we did look in here. Yeah, because that's where we just bought the freaking the meat, you dingus. Anyway, we might as well go back and use the six room, the four room to see what we can roll inside of the membership store and the store in general. A little bit less effective. It does not affect the devil deals. Yeah, we already know that. But it affects angel deals, I think. Let's see what the shop of Reno has re-rolled into Reno. So we get Sackhead, which is not bad. And that stayed the same. Okay. Yeah, I mean, we can take Sackhead. I'm down with Sackhead. Triple keys. Also down with that as well. So far, so good. But again, a very slow moving run here. Not necessarily because of our lack of movement speed. We have decent movement speed. It's not horrible, but it's not great. We do get an Emperor card here, which I am super duper stoked about. That's going to take us directly to the boss room whenever we are ready to use it. Figured I'd check. I mean, we have a couple of extra bombs here. Why not? That was Lost Contact or Shielded Tears, which wouldn't be horrible with Immaculate Heart. Sort of give us like a sort of pseudo floating or rotating shield of tears around us. But at the same time, it's like this is the last time that we get a chance to use a reroll pedestal for an item room in this run. Unless we do a victory lap, which is not gonna happen on this run. There's a sacrifice room here. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. If we do get the Tinted Skull and find the Fool card, we'll come back and play the sacrifice room. That way we can increase the amount of chance that we get to get an angel deal item. Angel deal in general. Almost made the same mistake I always make in this room, which is thinking that they're not going to fire that quickly. That's the problem with Immaculate Heart, is that it takes away, if we do, well, there's our second Guppy item, but we're obviously not going to use it right now. If IBS does proc the Hallowed Ground, we can't really keep it. Because it will get taken out by just the randomness of Immaculate Heart. Yeah, so I will re-roll this Lost Contact, but first I want to see what's inside of the shop just in case there's something good in here. There's not. I will take Bomber Boy. Oh, there's the Tinted Skull. I was looking for that. Glad I didn't go all the way around. Okay, so what we should do is we should play the Sac Room fully. Then use the Fool card, go fight Mom, use the Fool card, get out, take 9 lives, and then head on down to the next floor. Or as the kids say, the Flizzor. Right? Kids say that? No? No, they don't say Flizzor? Get the rosary out of random. I'm not going to take it because of nine. I mean, we're gonna take nine lives, so. Okay. Just a random ghost baby shows up, too. And now, since we have the increased angel deal chance, let's go get HP. And because we can heal for double, this full heart will heal us for triple. Well, we'll go up to three hearts, I mean. There we go. We'll go back. I'm not going to fight Gabriel. It's the moment of truth here, if we get our soul hearts on the ground or not. And we do. Hallelujah. Okay, so now we can freely take nine lives after we beat Mom, and we come out and hopefully get an angel deal or devil deal item. A fool card. We got our nine lives waiting for us inside the curse room. Regular old poop. And we can get a Stars card. Look at that. Uh-oh. Did not get any of them. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's going to be a problem with me there, OIBS. Going to be a problem with me. Because you see, the thing is that I thought you were only going to just simply drop, like, you know, regular bombs. Or, like, at the very worst, butt bombs with explosive diarrhea. Did not expect this to be a whole, we just drop giant bomber boy bombs, so... I mean, they weren't giant, but, like, you know, that makes it extremely hard to get around. Get Sarah from Transformation, which is A-okay with moi. And we got flying as well, so we can finally pick up this penny that's been taunting us for this entire level. You know what? I think, honestly, I think that IBS... If we really want to let this item shine, or at least try to shine in a polished turd sort of way, let's let this go up against Beast. And with Bomber Boy, let's see how much damage we can truly cause against her whenever it procs. Why not? So that was glitter bombs and something else. So we still get another store here. Soul of Lilith. Another Bobby. Still two or three of Guppy. We have a chance of getting Guppy on this floor. Not bloody likely, but it is possible. We could take starter deck as well, so we can carry two cards, but honestly, this is where the end of the line is for our Emperor card. So we're just going to use the Emperor card here because we don't need it. We don't need it for the Ascent. We get a random soul heart here. Yeah. Golden key as well. Squeezy, which is totally useless because we're already capped at five. Yeah, we should, I believe we should still have that item pedestal inside of the Ascent room, I believe. We could go put. No, we need this. We need this money to reroll. Yeah, we'll just use it for the reroll.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
Mr. Dolly gives us rain and tears.
You have spent our savings.
Let's flush and glitter bombs. Tractor beam. I think tractor beam cancels out. No, it doesn't. It doesn't cancel out Immaculate Heart. Interesting. I thought it would have. Well, if we didn't have, if we weren't already Captain Tears, like, you know, tractor beam would have been amazing for us. As it stands now, it's not really that much of an upgrade. Stars card lets us skip one room. Thank you very much, Stars card. Appreciate it. Get those big time plays. Now, I wonder what happens when IBS procs on Beast and we get like, we get the holy poop. We get like the streak, the creep streak down below like we just did. Does that persist in the item in the Beast run? I don't remember. Yeah, quit pushing him, Maggie.
We'll be fine without you. Abandon us, abandon yourself.
Which says my right to just say no to that room. I'm excited. I'm curious to see what Butt Bombs does with these, not Butt Bombs, IBS does. To Beast with the Bomber Boy effect. If we proc, if we end up proccing Explosive Diarrhea, that potentially is a lot of, that's a huge amount of damage. But the question is it worth it? And you know, it just depends on, you know, how much self damage you want to be done to you. Ancestors in the World card and Tower Bombs. Actually, you know what? Tower card might be not that bad against old Beastie. Especially with the Bomber Boy effect. Okay, good. Well, whatever. You can go ahead and use the Guppy's paw now, so we can at least have polar invincibility for some of these taps that we're getting. IBS, I think, is still pretty dangerous just because it does go off when you take a hit, and it also really limits you to what bomb effect you can take. So you see here, we got a tears up from Hurt So Good. Man, those Bomber Boy bombs we get from IBS, that is real strong in terms of our overall damage that we can cause. Just like, it's basically free damage. I'm kind of down with it. Bro, okay. Let's stop taking all of this stupid damage. How about that? Let's stop getting hit by these random shots. They're point blank and just splitting apart and just causing us all sorts of ridiculous troubles. Big old mega fat nope for me. All right, and here we go. So the new IBS versus old Beastie. Get three of those soul hearts back because we have an empty bed here and no red heart containers. And we should get a full rack of hearts when we get to Beast after we're done beating Dogma. Here we go. Wasn't sure how many books we've touched. Apparently not enough. So we dealt decent damage there with explosive diarrhea. Really good poison damage there on the TV. Wow. Imagine fighting this fallen angel creature thing and then throwing just like a big poison pile of Koopa. It's like, welcome to Earth. Down goes Dogma. A little bit of a wonky fight, especially with the back-to-back explosive diarrheas. And let's see how we do against old Beastie. Round one, here we go. Now, if you notice there on our HP bar, you see that we have the Holy Mantle effect that was given to us by Dogma. I'm not sure what happened to our IBS thing. I think maybe that was the creep streak, and it just doesn't do anything. That would have been nice. One little random shot. And our movement speed really is bad. Uh-oh. Not getting any interesting poops here. Bro. Wow. The instant detonation. Yeah, IBS. I don't know, man. Still seems like it's a pretty big bummer to have. If it didn't give us explosive diarrhea, I think it actually would not be all that terrible. And that goes war. Yeah, that was definitely the creep. And because I heard the sound effect and it didn't do anything. Let's see if we can stop death before he gets to the next phase. The answer is no. Oh, down he goes. There we go. All right. Gosh, they exploded instantly on her. So these bomber boy bombs should be doing tons of damage to her. There we go. That kind of worked. Hey. Now, never mind the fact that the poop piles in the background are somehow moving in the background, even though they're supposed to be in the foreground. That was a spicy one. Probably shouldn't be using that in the context of explosive diarrhea, but you know what? This game has poop jokes all over the place, and we're gonna deal with them. So down goes old Beastie. There you go. You got to see a firsthand look at the new IBS. And yeah, shout out to the sacrifice rooms for making the big time plays, because definitely they are worth doing if you have the HP. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, let me know in the comments down below how you are faring in the new patch thus far. What's your favorite change? What's your least favorite change? I'd love to see them in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. I do appreciate it. Some people have been telling me that the dislike counter is still active on the videos. I can see them from the creator's side, but I wasn't sure if they were still showing up publicly, as YouTube said that they were going to be hiding that. Apparently that's not a thing now. I don't know. So either way, hope you have a great start to your Friday, everyone. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And thank you for being a part of the Mosh Pit. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Drew Couch, Brattero, Bratwolf, Charleston, Joe Sandor, and Jade Fright. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.